When you think of it, in the 60s, if we look back nearly 50 years, the First World War hadn't even started. We were young, so we had all that new energy. This exhibition brings together all my visual work, which hasn't been done before.
It's my history, it's his history, it's our history in a particular period of London when suddenly we thought we would change the world and make it into a wonderful and better place for everybody. You know, the first time I traveled out
in the rain and snow. My connection to Nigel was I knew Nigel. Hoppy was my partner in UFO. He knew Michael English. He wanted Michael to do the posters. I wanted Nigel to do the posters. So in the very 60s way, we said, hey, let's put them in a room together and have them do them together. And the first thing they did was the gold candy striped UFO.
You know, these weren't for collectors or museums or art galleries. This was street art, mainly. This was ephemeral. These were statements.
It was so creative and oddly enough, not motivated by money. And it was only after we'd done thousands, issued, I don't know, maybe already about 10 or 15 different posters. We did a proper costing of it and realized we were making a loss because we were selling them for 7 and 6 pence and they were costing like 7 and 8 pence or something, you know, idiotic like that, you know.
Rather like graffiti today, where it's difficult to read the lettering, these too had that aspect about them. There's a slight sort of playfulness about it all. And they were very much more visual and graphic than they were wordy. Yes, we'll advertise The Who or Hendrix or whatever, but we'll make a very, you know, dramatic picture to go with it.
The scene in the 60s was really very, very small. So when Nigel Waymouth and John Pierce began Granny Takes a Trip in King's Road, everybody obviously went there for their clothes. They became absolutely iconic from the period. They were the ultimate psychedelic clothing as worn by the Beatles and Eric Clapton and the Pink Floyd.
In those days, people were very excited. They put on their velvet trousers and lived in them for 3 or 4 weeks and wondered why they split, you know. The 60s haven't ended in many ways. You know, there's much more consciousness of environment. There's more women's liberation. The race relations are much more liberal now than they were then. People are much more conscious of what the politics of peace are about now, especially with all these little wars everywhere. It's nice to know that our ideals have remained, you know, in principle true since then.